Hi, welcome to Enchiridion. Mastodonsaurus was an enormous amphibian with a short body and tail, and a massive flat skull. In a fully grown adult, the skull could be 5 feet long. Its jaws were packed with many small, sharp teeth, and a pair of tusks pointed up from its lower jaw, and through openings in the upper jaw. It is thought that Mastodonsaurus fed on fish which it caught in the lakes, ponds, and swamps where it lived. It was a temnospondyl amphibian that belonged to a group called Capitosauria, known for their relatively large body size and mostly aquatic lifestyles. The signature features of Mastodonsaurus are the two teeth in the front of the lower jaw that have enlarged to the point of becoming tusks. These are massive, so massive in fact, that there are two openings in the upper jaw which these tusks fit through when the mouth is closed. The tusks may have been for prey capture, allowing a Mastodonsaurus to get a grip upon prey. It may have also served as a display purpose to differentiate themselves. It was a piscivore and thus a carnivore that spent most, if not all, of its time in the water. There's great evidence for this. First, the head of Mastodonsaurus was so large that it took up almost a fourth of its body length, something that would have been cumbersome in land. Their eyes are situated midway on top of the skull, meaning that they were best placed for looking up at whatever may have been swimming above them. Additionally, its limbs were greatly reduced in size and would have been incapable of lifting the body clear off the ground if out of the water. The joints of these limbs are also weak, suggesting limited muscles. There is also further evidence for this lifestyle in its remains. It seems very, very likely that Mastodonsaurus was restricted to a lifetime in the water. The wide distribution of this creature across Europe might be due to flooded ancient river systems granting access to new locations. While its limbs were weak, they were likely plenty strong enough for aquatic life, where the weight of the body would have been supported by the water. It may have hunted fish, but also occasionally some other temnospondyl amphibians. Mastodonsaurus means breast-tooth lizard. The source of this was when Jager was describing a broken tooth. It was named by G.F. Jager in 1828. There are multiple synonyms such as Batrachosaurus, Labyrinthodon, and Mastodonsaurus conicus, among others. Species include M. giganteus, M. jageri, and M. torbus. It was between 13 to almost 20 feet long. Its skull was up to around 4 feet long, and there are also slight variations between species. It has been found in Europe, specifically in England, in the Bromsgrove sandstone formation, in Wales in the Sully Beds formation, in Germany in the Erfurt formation, and in Russia in the Bukobe formation. It lived during the Anisian through the Ration of the Triassic 230 million years ago. Fossil remains include those of multiple individuals. Thank you for watching. I like to say that these fact-based videos are the basis for the creation of an eventual website with 3D models of prehistoric creatures and a virtual reality experience or a virtual museum. Just imagine seeing one of these creatures in real life. I think that would be really cool. But until that, this is Enchiridion, and see you next time.